something strange in your neighborhood. Who you gonna call? If there's something weird and it don't look good, who you gonna call? That's right.
YouTubers, Hankster here, and welcome to our final little review involving the works of Ghostbusters. Now, we're going to go into the second animated series based on Ghostbusters. Now, I'm not talking about the one from Filmation. We're going to be going into what is called the second one connected to the movie, which, of course, is Ghostbusters Extreme. Now, yes, this series was connected to not only just the movies, but it was also connected to the original animated series, because most of the original voices from the series, from the original animated series, including, of course, Dave Coulier and Arsenio Hall, who, of course, played the voice of Ernie Hudson's character in the movie, returned a few times there. Now, of course, mostly it was the animated voice of Egon, who was one of the lead characters in the show. By this time in the series, Ghostbusters had basically gotten too old to do their job, and it was up to a new generation to take on the role, and it was up to Egon to teach them how to do that. Of course, Slimer also returned. Janine also returned for the series. I believe it was the same actress as well. And, of course, ran into a whole bunch of new villains, along with, I think, a few classic Ghostbusters animated series characters as villains as well. Now, of course, by this time, I guess they decided to make this series politically correct, with not just at all of one group. They kind of had a sort of quote-unquote multicultural assortment of characters. You had a Latino guy, a wisecracking Latino guy. You had a black guy, a white guy on a wheelchair, and, of course, a girl. So trying to make it politically correct, and I think even lesser so than what they're trying to do now with the upcoming third movie, with the so-called all-female cast. It wasn't too bad. I mean, they worked together. It was not the politically correct and the multicultural ideas that we didn't ruin the series. The animation was pretty good. It was just a continuation of the original animated series, with mostly a little bit of a new cast. It was basically a passing of the torch between the new generation and old generation. So, and as I said, there was even an episode where the original Ghostbusters came back to help out the new generation as well, and that wasn't too bad either. But it didn't last as long, obviously. I think it lasted maybe a season or two in syndication, as opposed to the real Ghostbusters being on ABC for well into the next decade, from the mid '80s to the early part of the '90s. But all in all, it's not too bad to see, how things, of course, the attitudes of the late 90s added into it. So, that's why it's called Ghostbusters Extreme. New technology and all was thrown in there as well, with, what they used to catch ghosts and all. So, that wasn't too bad. And, but I just hope you enjoyed this little review of the second animated Ghostbusters series. Of course, we're not totally done here yet. We got two more reviews, and they're not going to be any movie or TV reviews. This is going to be our first video game review, and it's going to be the highly popular Ghostbusters video game that came out a few years ago, which is basically what you could call Ghostbusters 3, even though it was a video game and not a movie. And that was just because that most of the actors and actresses from the original movie had returned to do this video game, and of course except for Sigourney Weaver, of course. But we'll be getting into the depth of this movie, and also we'll be focusing on a recent collectible I just got from Ghostbusters. And of course, it's Vince Clortho, a.k.a. Lewis Tully, the action figure from Mattel. We'll be showing him off in an upcoming review as well. So I hope you enjoyed this review, and stay tuned here for more reviews and whatnot here on the Multiverse. See ya.